Let's go to the country, y'all. In a mean world like this, what we need the Lord to do? To send a revival along.
Send a revival.
Send a revival along.
Send a revival.
Send a revival along.
Send a revival.
Send a revival,
Lord. Send a revival.
Excited now? Are you awake now? Were you getting your step in? I got mine in. I like that quartet music. Praise God. I miss Keith Wonderboy. Praise the Lord. I enjoyed that song. Listen, you know the name to call on. His name is Jesus. You want him to save in your family? Ask him to save. You want him to heal? Ask him to heal. You want him to move? Ask him to move. He's a gentleman. He will do what you ask. He will not force himself. Hallelujah. And you'll reap the benefits of calling on the name of Jesus. For there is no other name under heaven that we can call on and be saved and be healed and be delivered and for him to move in us the breath of life. Spirit of the living God, we want it to breathe on us. Amen. I thank God for his word today. What would we do without the word? Don't you go nowhere. We got a word coming up at the top of the hour. God has a fresh word for us for this day that we can grow in the knowledge and grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But I want to encourage you that every Monday through Friday, tune in at 4 to listen to Pastor Franklin Hobbs. He is the host of Heal Our Land. Enjoy hanging out with him. I tell you, you will be blessed by hearing our brother, who is a pastor here at Global Ministries Christian Church. And he is my brother in Christ, and I thank God for him. You know, I listen to the other broadcasts. We support one another here at Global Ministries. Why? we have one mission in mind. That is to reach the lost for Christ and creating a Christian community to walk with brothers and sisters in healing and growth, maturity, and wholeness. God cares about each and every one of us and every detail in our lives. And we here are trying and striving to do the will of God, reaching out. It's not about me, myself, and I. It's not about me and just my household, but it goes beyond that. It goes out into the world. The word of God, Jesus told us to go out into all the world. That's right. He didn't say how. Thank God for technology, because we get to use all different methods to go out and share the good news of the gospel worldwide. And I am so privileged to be a part of that. But I just want to encourage you to listen to Pastor Franklin Hobbs Monday through Friday from 4 to 6. I tell you, you'll be blessed. Amen. And I want to encourage you to continue to listen and watch here live. And I wanted to remind you that you can listen to the broadcast audibly on your landline and your cell phone. And the phone number is 712-432-4402. So you see, you can listen to us at home and while you're on the go, just by phone. Amen. Isn't God good? So you can take Jesus with you, not only in your heart, but audibly. Amen. Because we are sharing the good news of the gospel. Again, that phone number is 712-432-4402. When I found out that that phone number worked for my home landline, I cannot express how excited I was. I've been hanging on there and have to make sure I charge my phone because the battery gets low. But I've been enjoying the word, the music, all the inspiration that God has for us here at Boston Praise Radio. We're going to go back to listening to Keith Wonderboy, and the next song is Angels.
That I'm covered with his blood from head to toe. He's sending his angel to watch over me wherever I may go. I know I got an angel
watching over me.
I know for myself.
Look back over my life.
Send me an angel, 'cause he said he'll never forsake me. Flames falling out the sky, people dying every day, but no harm has come upon me, because I know he kept me covered.
Valleys
help me say, yeah.
I know I've got an angel.
watching me.
Have there ever been a time when you was riding in your car?
He's watching me.
And a car came out of nowhere and just missed
He's
you.
He's watching me.
It wasn't your good luck. It wasn't your
He's
good driving.
Me.
But it was an angel.
Oh, yes.
If you know he did it for you. Lift your voice and say, yeah. Tell you why I know
He's watching me.
Living in a big city like
oh,
New York.
Yes,
He's taking place
me.
Every minute. Some of our communities
are
filled with
me.
Drugs. Gangs are taking over. Drive-by shootings
me.
All the time. Some of our children are dying on
He's
the streets. But the Lord kept His loving arms
oh,
around me.
Yes,
that's
He's
enough to lift my
me.
Hands and say the Lord. Hit New York, it was very personal to me. I love my daddy, but Lord knows I'm a mama's boy. And my mama, she works in the World Trade Center. I didn't hear from my mama, but then I got down on my knees and said, Lord, I know you're watching over me and my family. Then an hour went by and I heard from my mama. I said, thank you. Thank you, Lord. My mama was all right. The same way He watches over me. He'll do it for you. Yeah.
Lord, no matter how much you bless me, I realize that I couldn't make it without you in my life. Let me testify about how I feel right now. There were times when I was going through, in the midst of my storms, didn't know what to do. Even though I was down, the Lord taught me to realize I never would have made it without you in my life. No, I never would have made it without you in my life. I'm gonna say it again. Times when I was going through, in the midst of my storm, didn't know what to do. Even though I was down, the Lord taught me to realize that I never would have made it without you in my life. Oh, I never would have made it without you in my life.
Praise the Lord. The word of God says, blessed be the Lord who daily loadeth us with benefits. Amen. Aren't you glad for the benefits of the Lord? All that he does for us, he doesn't have to do it, but he does because he loves us with an everlasting love. Praise God. Aren't you glad about the angels? You got angels watching over you. That's what the word says. They encamp round about us that no evil would befall us. Amen. Thank God for the angels. Thank God for goodness and mercy. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I made it. Where would I have been had it not been for the Lord who is on my side? I never would have made it. But today I rejoice, so glad I made it, all because of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You're listening to Boston Praise Radio with yours truly, Janice Hayes, broadcasting live at Global Ministries Christian Church, 670 Washington Street, Dorchester, Massachusetts. If you need further information, our phone number is 617-282-0685. And I'd like to take the time to invite you to our Friday night service. Start at 7 p.m. We have prayer. You are invited. Bring your family. Bring a friend. Bring some friends. We'd love to meet and greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know, the Word of God tells us to faint not. You know, don't forget about praying. To continue to pray. Thank you, Holy Ghost. To pray without ceasing. And you wonder why? Why do we need to pray without ceasing? So that we, our hearts, don't get faint about things that are happening all around us, around the world. Life happens, situations occur, troubles, burdens, struggles, trials, tribulations. But if we cease not in praying, our hearts will stay continually encouraged in the Lord because we are keeping our eyes on the Lord when we pray. We are keeping our minds on his word when we pray. So you see, prayer is a tool and we need that. Amen. So don't forget to pray today. Pray every day. It doesn't mean be on your knees all day long. If that's where God has you, you do what the Holy Spirit leads you. But, you know, along in your daily routine, when you're washing dishes, changing the baby, or at your job, whatever you're doing, wherever you are, walking down the street, driving in your car, mowing the lawn, watering them flowers, you know, whatever it is you're doing, don't forget to pray. Don't forget to pray for someone else, because what that does for us, when we take our minds off ourselves and pray for the needs of someone else, we project that love and the power of the Lord towards someone else and praying for their need. And in the meantime, God is working on our situation. Amen. So you see, we need each other. I need you and you need me. We're all a part of God's body. It is his will that every need he will supply. So remember, we need to pray without ceasing. Amen. Glory to God. Let's go back to listening to Keith Wonderboy. Now God is able.
God is able.
To carry you through.
Makes no difference.
It doesn't matter
what the world say or
what
do.
What they say or do.
Go to God.
Go to God in prayer.
Then you can leave.
To see you through.
Stop complaining right now.
to how he set you free. He gave you the victory. Celebrate it. Tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank the Lord.
Thank you.
I'm not gonna complain about it.
Thank
I'm gonna stay here on my knees.
Thank you.
Tell the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank you.
My God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I got to.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
I got to.
Thank you.
Sometimes you got to stop begging God for things and just thank him for what he's already done. Y'all thought I was finished, but I got to tell him a thank a thank a thank a thank you. If you thankful for what he's done for you, you ought to give him a dance. Tell the Lord thank you.
I said
thank you. I said thank you. I said thank you. I want to thank you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Do you thank the Lord for what he's done for you? Think about where he's brought you from. Think about where things were last week, a month ago, 6 months ago, a year ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago. Thank the Lord for what he's done for you. That's my testimony. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. What is our testimony? I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who laid down his life for me and shed his blood to wash my sin and make me free. That's our testimony. Hallelujah. That's how we make it over. Praise God each and every day. And do you know God is able? Can you say that? Has he brought you through some things? Has he made way when there seemed to be no way? Did he make a way out of no way? Did he show up and show out? Hallelujah. When everyone and everything else fail, God never fails. For with man, things are impossible. But with God, nothing shall be impossible. Hallelujah. Thank God for his word. Amen. You're listening to Boston Praise Radio with yours truly, Janice Hayes. I've been enjoying Keith Wonderboy. I'm telling you, I'm here having a wonderful time in the Lord. I'm getting my praise on. I love quartet music. And when I get the chance to have that treat, it's me and the Holy Ghost. Oh, yeah. I love it. I just thank God for his goodness, and I am so privileged to be in your company. Thank you for listening and viewing and for fellowshipping with me. I thank God for you, because had it not been for you and the Lord, where would I be? I wouldn't be here with you. It's all his doing. He is good. Amen. Let's go back to some music. We're going to go to Lord Help Me. Amen. Enjoy yourself. He says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Amen.
Journey,
Lord,
on my way.
Oh, Lord,
please, Lord, I want you to help me. Thanks to Mass Housing, the Bias family went from a rented basement apartment in Chelsea to a single-family home in Revere. Jose Bias secured his mortgage through Mass Housing with a down payment of just 3%. Then he turned his house into a home.
For anyone that has any doubts about Mass Housing, the process was easy. We didn't ever think it was possible to ever own our own home.
Home ownership is within your reach. Make Mass Housing your home team. Visit Mass Housing at masshousing.com.
To you, help me say thank you.
Thank you.
just got so much to be thankful for. He blessed some of you with cars or home. And you know you had bad credit. You ought to open up your mouth right now and tell the Lord, thank you. Some of you out there, you got a job and you know you are unqualified. But tell the Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Trying to get my business fixed. Cause I don't know about you, I wanna go to heaven. Fellas, help me say.
Talk to them, but remember my friend, God forgave him, so why can't you?
Praise the Lord. You're listening to Boston Praise Radio with yours truly, Janice Hayes. It's time for Word. Hallelujah. You need the Lord's help. You've been trying to work it out yourself. You've been trying to figure it out. Trying to figure out what works good and what doesn't work. What to do and how to do it. You know, there's only one wise God. And that is the only true and living God. He knows everything. He knows what to do, how to do it, when to do it, and for whom. That's God, the only wise God. We need him. Amen? So is that your prayer today? Lord, I need you. Help me. I need your help, Lord. You know, life happens. God wants us to realize that we need him. And also, not to be afraid of him, reverence and respect him, and fear him, and keep his commandments and his laws, his word, but not be afraid of him. And to come to him all the time with everything. There is nothing you can tell the Lord that would surprise him. He knows everything. He sees everything. He hears everything. He's in every place at one time. Praise God. That's El Shaddai, the Lord God who is almighty. Praise the Lord. We are in the book of 1 John. And I want to thank you for listening and viewing. And if you've been praying for me, I want to thank you for your prayers. And if you haven't, I'm thanking you in advance. We desire your prayers here at Boston Praise Radio as we pray for you. Let us pray one for the other. That's what the Word of God tells us to do. Amen. Praise God. We are coming out of the first book of John in the New Testament. Praise the Lord. I truly enjoy Keith Wonderboy today. Amen. Okay, let's go to God. Father God, we thank you for this privilege and this honor to be in your presence. We thank you, hallelujah. Oh God, we thank you for being in our midst. We thank you for your goodness to us. For God, you are gracious to us, oh God, and you are merciful to us. And oh God, you love us with an everlasting love, and you continually draw us with your loving kindness. So God, we want to say thank you. Hallelujah, we want to say thank you for all that you do for us, Lord, for another day of life, health, and strength. Another day to be in your presence, oh God. Another day for the privilege and the honor to come before your throne as your own and to call upon your holy and righteous name. Oh God, we reverence you. Hallelujah. There is none like you in all the earth, oh God. You are the only true and living God, and we worship you, Lord. We love you because you first loved us. We thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for your Holy Ghost, and we thank you for your Holy Word. Hallelujah. We just want to bless your name, Lord. We just want to love on you right now, God. And we are thankful unto you, and we bless your name. We are grateful unto you, O God, who is good to us. Hallelujah. Not because we deserve it, but because you are good. Father, we ask that you bless this time that we come together in your word. Feed our hungry souls today in the name of Jesus. Oh God, give us understanding and clarity what you're saying to us. Speak to our situations, oh God. Bless us to grow in the knowledge and grace of your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, don't let us be the same in Jesus' name, and don't let us go back the way we came. But bless us, oh God, to press forward toward the mark of the prize of the high calling of God through Christ Jesus. Help us, Lord. Bless us, Lord. Minister to our hearts today through your word. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. For you are my Lord, my God, my Redeemer, my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name, have your way. Let the people of God say, amen. Hallelujah. You know, the Lord is just so good. I am just overjoyed about God's love and his word and for what he's doing in my life, the things that he's teaching me, even with the inconveniences and the discomforts. I give him praise. I thank him because he's working it all out for my good. I am the called, and I am called according to his purpose. I belong to God. And my brothers and sisters, we all have that same word. Amen. Because that's the word of God. Praise God. We've been talking about John. And John was sharing a message with us in the first book of John, 2 John, 3 John. And the letters that he wrote to us are what the Bible calls epistles. And in these letters, he is concerned about the spiritual welfare of every believer. And what he wants us to know is that he is concerned about us, and he's sharing his experience in the Word of God, the fellowship that he had with the Father and the Son, and the fellowship that he had with other believers. So if you will, it's like he's passing the torch down to us. And in the book, and in 1 John, 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John, John is an apostle. And in writing these letters, he is sharing with us, and he's showing concern. And he's also showing us affection. If you get the chance, you just look through 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John, and you'll see where beloved is mentioned quite a few times. And that beloved is the people of God, the body of Christ, brothers and sisters in Christ, children of God, heirs of God and joint heirs of Christ, children adopted by God, God's own elect. Meaning us. So he's showing us concern, and he's also showing us affection, you know, because the Bible says that the world would know us by the love of God that's in us. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, when talking about the message in regards to conditions for fellowship, the message that John is writing to us is very simple. It is that God is light. And where there is light, darkness cannot stay. So the scripture says God is light, and in him there is no darkness. Amen. Now, let's go to the word. 1 John, the first chapter. I'm going to pick up again at verse 7, and I'm going 7 through 10. But if we walk in God's light, as Jesus walked in God's light, then we are his friends and have fellowship with each other. And the blood of Jesus Christ will cleanse us from all sin. If we say we've never sinned, or if we refuse to admit that by nature we're sinners, we're deceiving ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to clean us up from all unrighteousness. Verse 10, if we say we've never sinned, or if we refuse to admit that we have a sinful nature, we're saying that God is a liar and that what he told us in the scriptures is not true. This would prove that the word of God is not a part of our lives, no matter what we say. May God add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word. Now, Tuesday, I was sharing with you about being in fellowship with God and being in fellowship with one another, walking in the light, if you will. So you wonder, what does walking in the light mean? Well, the scripture says that God is light. And walking in the light, we come into the light through Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Now, God is the light. He is holy and he is pure. And in him, there is no darkness at all. So in our lives as sinners, sin causes us to be dark, no light, no righteousness, no fellowship through Jesus Christ and the Father, no eternal life, no inheritance to the kingdom of God. Sin separates us from God. And where there is sin, God will not dwell. Amen? So when we talk about light, God is that light that exposes sin and cleans it up. That's how powerful God's light is. He doesn't just shine in, but it shines in, exposes, and cleanses. Amen? Now let's talk about fellowship. What does fellowship mean? Fellowship means to be in association or in relation or in communication. Now we say fellowship with who? Fellowship with people and fellowship with God. Now to come into fellowship with God the Father, we have to come through Jesus Christ, who is the Savior of the world. The Bible says that Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father except through me. So to get to the Father, we need to come through Jesus Christ first. And once we come to Jesus and we're accepted into the family of God after we have confessed our sin and repented, we have been adopted by God, and we become heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. Well, when we accept the Lord Jesus Christ in our hearts by faith and ask for forgiveness of sin, God comes in to our lives. And when he comes in, where the Bible says he is light, he is shining. Amen. So when God comes in our lives, we come into fellowship with him and with other believers. Amen. So we fellowship with God through Jesus Christ because we're in relationship with Jesus, and we fellowship with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Amen. Now, to walk in the light, that means to walk in obedience to God's word. Being obedient to God's word, we strive to please God every day by the help of the Holy Ghost and by the reading, teaching, preaching, and learning of God's word in this training of righteousness. How do we walk in the light? The light that comes in us, the power of the Holy Ghost, he is the one that empowers us to walk in the light. Because of ourselves, we cannot do it. Because of our human nature. Our human nature is at enmity, or if you will, is an enemy of God. Human nature, our human nature wants to do what it wants to do. Wants to be boss. Wants to tell everybody and everything what to do and how it is. God is God, and there is no other God beside him. Amen? So we must remember that. Praise God. Now, when walking in the light, there are two results. One is you get to fellowship with other believers. Amen? The other result is continual cleansing from sin. You know, when you turn the light out and you turn it on again, what was dark? And then when you turn the light on, what was dark is not hidden anymore. Amen? So that's what the light of God does in us. It continually reveals and cleanses sin in our lives. Maybe not what we're doing every day, but in our thoughts, in our attitudes, in the way we do things, you know, because in our hearts. Who can see the heart but God? Who is greater than our heart but God? Now, when we do wrong, sin, unrighteousness, the Holy Ghost is the one that convicts us of sin, whether we are a sinner or whether we're a sinner saved by grace, which means a saint of God, a child of God. The Holy Ghost always convicts of wrongdoing. That's part of his job. Amen? Now, getting back to the message, what is the message? That God is light. Amen. Understanding that since we are walking in the light brings other sin that needs cleansing from our lives. Now, if we look at, which verse? Verse 9. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sin and to cleanse us up from all unrighteousness. That scripture, that's not the one I wanted. The one I wanted was verse 7. But if we walk in God's light as Jesus walked in God's light, then we are his friends and have fellowship with each other. And the blood of Jesus Christ will cleanse us from all sin. Now, I want to view in on cleanse. In the King James Version, it says cleanseth. And the ETH means continual. So it would be continual cleansing. Cleansing from what? From all sin. So you see, when God comes into our lives, he comes in to make a change spiritually in us, because he knows that of ourselves, we don't have the power, we don't have the know-how because of our human nature. Amen? So he is the power that comes in and cleanses us from sin. Now, in the book of Romans 3:23, the scripture says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." You see, all of us were born into sin. Not one of us was born out of sin. All of us were born in sin. And to come out of sin, we need to be forgiven of sin. And that is only through Jesus Christ. God is the only one that can forgive sin. Now, I want to go to Psalms 32. With you, because you know, sometimes people say, well, I'm not a bad person. I'm not a bad person. I say my grace. I go to church. I sing in the choir. I sing on the praise team. I'm an usher. I'm a deacon. I visit the homeless. I go to the hospitals. You know, we talk about all these good deeds that we do, but you know, all of our righteousness, all the goodness or good deeds or goodness about ourselves is as filthy rags. God doesn't, he's not glorified out of doing things our way. It's got to be his way through his son, Jesus Christ, and by the power of the Holy Ghost that works with us and his word that comes alive in us as the word is taught to us, preached to us, and in prayer. Amen. We need all those tools to work together. Praise God. Now, some, you know, we think, getting back to sin, sometimes people don't understand about sin. Sometimes people don't understand what sin is and what a sinner is and why we are called sinners. Amen. Well, let's read in Psalms, the 32nd chapter, verses 1 through 5. Okay, and it reads, "Happy is the man who knows that his sins are forgiven and that his mistakes will not be mentioned. Happy is the man whose wrongs the Lord does not hold against him and who is accepted as if he had never sinned. When I kept my sin to myself," now this is talking about David. We're talking about David here. "When I kept sin to myself, I seemed to grow old. All day long, my heart groaned inside me. Day and night, I was under conviction, and my strength slipped away as if it were a hot summer day. Then I decided to confess my sin to you." He's talking to the Lord. "And write what was wrong. I said to myself, I will acknowledge my sin and transgressions to the Lord and ask him for forgiveness. And you forgave me and took away my load of guilt." Amen. So you see, that helps us to understand what sin is, what it does, how it makes us feel. Sin affects us physically, and it affects us emotionally. That being separated from our Heavenly Father and not having his Son in our hearts by faith. To be forgiven is a blessing. Forgiveness is a blessing. Forgiveness causes us to feel relieved, to feel the heavy load lifted off of us. You see, because sin is a burden. Sin is a heavy load that we carry of wrongdoings. If you don't ever confess or repent of your sin, you carry that heavy load in your life all your life. You may think, well, I'm not carrying it, but you know what? When you get by yourself at night and you think about it, the weight of sin shows as a result in your physical being and in your emotions. Who is greater than our hearts? God. When we do wrong, who convicts us? His Holy Ghost. None of us are exempt from the conviction of the Holy Ghost. When we do wrong, when we live in sin, when we are in unrighteousness, when we are doing wrong, the Holy Ghost's job is to convict us of our wrongdoing. So you see, it's going to show up one way or another. You can say, I don't agree. I'm not going to admit that I sin. But if you do that, the Word of God tells you that you call God a liar. Now, sin separates us from God. And to know that, to not accept what God says as the truth, we deceive ourselves. Amen. We deceive ourselves of the truth. What is the truth? The truth is the Word of God. The truth is the Word of life, who is Jesus Christ. So you see, we need to understand what sin is. Sin is wrongdoing. What is a sinner? A sinner is one that has not repented of their sin and that lives in wrongdoing and in unrighteousness. But God wants us to understand today that we don't have to stay in sin, because remember, he loves us with an everlasting love in Jeremiah 31 and 3. And he will continue to love us and help us. And he is drawing us always with his loving kindness. Amen. So you see, he's always working with us because of that love that he has for us. Now today, in having unrighteousness in our lives, we don't have to live that way anymore. God made the way out through his son, Jesus Christ. Jesus came and laid down his life, and his blood was shed for us, that we can be forgiven of our sin. The scripture says to us, if we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, when God forgives our sin, he doesn't hold on to a tally slip, a long slip, and he keeps itemizing everything you do. God doesn't do that to us. When we go to him and we confess, Lord, I'm a sinner. Lord, I've sinned. He's listening. He's listening. And he's also looking at your heart. So when you go to God, you always go to God reverencing him, honoring him with respect. And you must believe in your heart that he hears you and that he's there to do whatever it is that needs to be done in your life, whatever you ask him for. You must believe that he's going to work it out for you. You just can't go to him and not believe in him. It doesn't work that way. The Bible says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. Your soul shall be saved when you confess and repent of your sin. And whatever your troubles are, you shall be saved from your troubles or your fears. But you have to believe that he will do it. Amen. And believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, there is a blessing of forgiveness. Sin weighs on us physically and emotionally. When we confess, God forgives us. When we confess, what it really means is that we are saying the same thing about sin that God says. And what that means is we agree with what God says. We agree, we admit, we acknowledge. So that puts us on one accord with God, according to his word and his way. Okay? That, don't ever forget that. As long as you hold on to what God's word says to you, you can pray that back to God. And it will always encourage you. The Bible says that the Holy Ghost brings all things back to our remembrance. Amen. And I'm a witness of that. He'll bring it back just when you need to hear it or just when you need to share it. Amen. Now, today, understanding and knowing that the Word of God says that God is light. And to confess means to acknowledge. We must know what God's word is saying to us. Agree and acknowledge that we are sinners and that all of our righteousness is as filthy rags. There's only one righteous and holy one, and that is God the Father and his Son Jesus Christ and the Holy Ghost. For us to turn away from sin and not be sinners anymore, we need to confess, acknowledge our sin. Then we need to repent. And in repenting, we ask God to forgive us. And the blessing with that, being forgiven of sin, we are washed in the blood of Jesus Christ that cleansing our sin day by day. Isn't that awesome? Our God is truly good to us. So today I'd like to invite someone who hasn't accepted Jesus Christ in the pardoning of their sin to acknowledge that you are a sinner and that Jesus came to save you from your sin. Why? That you can be adopted back into the family of God and that your sin would be forgiven. You would be washed in the precious blood that Jesus shed on the cross of Calvary for you, that you would receive the gift of salvation and as an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ, you will inherit the kingdom of God. Isn't that powerful? How he loves us. If you'd like to make that decision today, make that choice to accept Jesus Christ in the pardoning of your sin, you just repeat after me. Father, I hear your word today. Heavenly Father, that your Son Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. I would like to be adopted into your family, and I would like to invite your Son into my heart by faith. Lord Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart by faith. I confess of my sin that I am a sinner. And I ask that you forgive my sin and that you would wash me in your precious blood. Wash away all my sin and unrighteousness. Thank you for forgiving me of my sin. Thank you for washing away my sin. Thank you for making me a part of your family. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I want you to know all of heaven's host is rejoicing over every person that just prayed that prayer of faith. Heaven is rejoicing over every soul that repents. And you know, repentance is a part of our daily prayer. Please remember that. We cannot say that we do not sin because our human nature does. But we have an advocate with the Father that we can go to Jesus and through Jesus go to God and ask for forgiveness of our sin. Every day, when you know that you've done the wrong thing, said the wrong thing, you can ask for forgiveness right where you are. Does this mean that you just continue to do whatever you want to do according to your human nature? No. It's not a license to continue to walk in sin. It is not a license to frustrate the grace of God. But understand, God loves you. And when you know the truth is what's going to make you free. Jesus is the person of truth. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So understand, when you are convicted about your wrongdoing and you go to God and you confess your sin and you repent of your sin, God hears you and he's there for you. He will forgive when you repent. But the thing is, you have to understand that you are responsible and accountable. That does not mean that you can only go to God a few times about it or whatever. But you know what? You keep practicing holiness. Holiness is humbling yourself, submitting yourself to God daily. And with a humble attitude, a humble heart, you want to please God. You no longer want to do the things of your old nature. This is a day-by-day thing. And you understand that as long as you keep going to God and asking God to forgive you with your whole heart, not with any hidden agendas. See, you got to be honest. We worship God in spirit and in truth. We cannot worship God in living lies and not being honest. He requires us to live a life of integrity before him. So as long as you are continuing to strive in God, remember, you can always go to him. He wants you to come to him. When you do the wrong thing, don't act like you didn't do it. Don't act like you didn't say it. Go to God and get it right. He will bless your life. He will bless you to grow. Those old struggles and habits that you used to have, you won't have them anymore. Why? Because that new person, that new identity, the new character of God is forming in your life. Remember, God is light. And where God is, there cannot be any darkness. So the more you call upon the name of the Lord, the more he comes in. The more you listen to his word, the more you learn and grow. Remember, it's a learning, growing, and cleansing process spiritually. And repentance is a part of our daily prayer. Amen. Be encouraged today. Now, I'd like to pray with my brothers and sisters, whatever needs you may be experiencing, situations. Maybe it's something you've been talking to God about already. But you know, God wants us to remember those of us that are believers and fellowship one with another and in the Holy Ghost. That should we sin, we are to repent, confess and repent, and turn away. That's for each and every one of us. Confess, repent, and turn away. How do we turn away? By turning to God and asking God for his help. Amen. Because he will help us. I am a living witness to that. He will help us. So today, if you have some habits, or you got some struggles, you got some addictions, some customs, some traditions that are not godly, we can go to God about that today. Let's go to God. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity and this privilege that we can come before your presence and your throne called your own. Father, we lift every brother and sister right now in the name of Jesus. Every habit, every addiction, every tradition, every custom, every ritual that is not godly. Father, we lift it before you in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray, oh God, that you would bring about a change. Your word says, for the Lord is good and his mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth to all generations. Father, let your truth endure down through every generation. The truth of God, the truth of love, the truth of peace, healing, salvation, deliverance. You are a deliverer to your people, oh God. Those of us that call upon you day and night, meet our every need, deliver from every addiction, every affliction, every ritual, everything that is not like you, God. Uproot it, take it out, in the name of Jesus Christ. And then, oh God, we ask you to fill it with your presence, your light, your love, your peace, and your joy. And Father, we ask that you wash us in the blood of Jesus Christ again, for there is no harm in doing that. We thank you for the blood-bought right that we can ask you to do it repeatedly. And those of us, oh God, that need the infilling, the indwelling, the baptism of the Holy Ghost, I pray in the name of Jesus for the baptism of the Holy Ghost in the lives of every believer listening and viewing in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, have your way in our lives. Make us what you want us to be. Move in us, oh God, like never before. Have your way. We thank you for what you are doing right now. And we thank you for what you're about to do. And we thank you, oh God, for where you have brought us from. You are our Heavenly Father. We are your children. You are the Good Shepherd, and we are the sheep of your pasture. We bless and honor you, Father. And in the name of Jesus Christ, we say thank you. We give you praise, glory, and honor. Have your way. Be in the midst of the lives of every believer, babes in Christ, all the way through each generation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise God. I am so grateful to God for his goodness and for his word. I thank him for his word. His word is truly good. All his promises are yea and amen. Amen. Praise God. We're going to go to music right now. We're going to go back to listening to Keith Wonderboy. Praise God. Thank you for listening and viewing.
Thanks to Mass Housing, the Bias family went from a rented basement apartment in Chelsea to a single-family home in Revere. Jose Bias secured his mortgage through Mass Housing with a down payment of just 3%. Then he turned his house into a home.
For anyone that has any doubts about Mass Housing, the process was easy. We didn't ever think it was possible to ever own our own home.
Home ownership is within your reach. Make Mass Housing your home team. Visit Mass Housing at masshousing.com.
Thank you. It'll all be over after a while. Oh Lord, it'll all
be over
after a while.
After a while.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
in this kingdom,
kingdom we'll meet.
We're gonna sit at,
his feet.
It'll all
be over
after a while.
After a while.
Oh, oh.
Check!
Praise the Lord, everybody. My time is wrapping up. Let go and let God. You've been listening to A Word with Janice Hayes at Boston Praise Radio. We love you here. We're praying for you. Don't forget, I'm here every Tuesday and Thursday from 12 noon to 2, broadcasting live. It's been a privilege and a delight to fellowship with you. Thanks for joining me. Don't forget, God is the light, and in Him there is no darkness. But continue to go to Him for every need. Hallelujah. Don't forget, GFM, God favors me, and that means you. God bless.
Boston Praise Radio, the voice of the church in New England. The views and opinions expressed by the following paid program are those of the program producers, and they do not reflect the views and opinion of Boston Praise Radio, its staff.